This video is on the topic of bond energies and the calculations associated with them. During a chemical reaction, bonds between atoms in the reactants are broken and new bonds between atoms in the products are formed. Energy needs to be taken in to break bonds, so bond breaking is an endothermic process. Energy is released when new bonds are formed, so bond making is an exothermic process. Chemical bonds have a specific bond energy associated with them. A bond energy is the amount of energy needed to break the bond or the amount of energy given out when a bond is formed. Bond energies can be used to determine the enthalpy change for a reaction. This is the change in heat energy. If more energy is released when new bonds are formed than what was taken in to break the bonds, then the reaction is exothermic. The product will have less energy than the reactant, and so the enthalpy change will be negative. Alternatively, if more energy is taken in to break the bonds than what is released when new ones are formed, then the reaction is endothermic. The product will have more energy than the reactant due to taking in energy, and the enthalpy change will be positive. To help you remember which way round exo and endothermic reactions work in terms of energy, then use exo equals energy exits to help you. You must be able to use bond energies to calculate the enthalpy change for a reaction. This example asks you to calculate the enthalpy change for the combustion of methane. You will always be given a table with the bond energies in and the displayed formula for the reactants and products. First, you need to determine the total energy taken in to break the bonds and then calculate the total energy released when new bonds are made. It's helpful to separate out your reactants and products to do this. First, identify the bonds present in the reactants. In this case, you have a carbon-hydrogen bond and an oxygen-oxygen double bond. Then identify how many of each bond you have and multiply that number by the bond energy in the table. This is the step that most students do incorrectly, so it can be helpful to cross out the bonds as you count them. There are four carbon-hydrogen bonds which we can cross off here, and we multiply that by the bond energy 412 to achieve 1648. The equation indicates there are two molecules of oxygen, so there are two oxygen-oxygen double bonds. Again, multiply this number by the bond energy in the table, 498, to give you 996. Add these values together to find the total energy required to break the bonds. This gives you a total value of 2,644 kilojoules per mole. Achieving this number will give you one mark. Then do the same for the other side. The bonds present are a carbon-oxygen double bond and hydrogen-oxygen single bond. There are two carbon-oxygen double bonds, which we can cross off here, and again, multiply this number by the bond energy in the table. And similar to the oxygen, there are also two molecules of water. Some students find it helpful to draw out the molecules fully so that they can see the total number of bonds. As we can see here, there are four bonds in total, so we're going to multiply the four by the bond energy given in the table to give 1,856. Again, we add these values together to get the total amount of energy released when the new bonds are formed, which is 3,466 kilojoules per mole. Calculating this number will also score one mark. To calculate the enthalpy change, the energy released is taken away from the energy taken in. This gives us a total enthalpy change of minus 822 kilojoules per mole. This will score the final mark. In this case, we have achieved a negative answer. The enthalpy change for an exothermic reaction is negative, so this reaction is exothermic. A positive answer would have indicated an endothermic reaction. It's really important that you show all you're working out for these calculations. Most students lose marks, not because the calculation is too difficult, but because they miscount the number of bonds that are being broken or formed. More complicated examples will require you to identify multiple types of bonds that can easily be missed. Follow the same method that we did in the previous example, and remember to draw your displayed formula if you are not already given it. Again, separate your reactant and product, and start by identifying the types of bond present in the reactant. Looking at the reactants, we can see the following bonds. Next, you need to count the number for each bond and multiply it by its bond energy. Remember to take into account the number of molecules for each substance. There are six carbon-hydrogen bonds, two carbon-oxygen bonds, two oxygen-hydrogen bonds, and three oxygen-oxygen double bonds. Add these numbers together to find out the total energy needed to break the bonds. This gives you a number of 5,410 kilojoules per mole and will score you one mark. Repeat this process for the product. Identify the types of bonds that you have and the number for each one, multiplying this by its bond energy and adding your totals together to give you a total amount of energy that is released when these bonds are formed. This gives us a value of 6,932 and will score your second mark. Take the energy out away from your energy in to achieve your total enthalpy change, which gives you a value of -1,522 kilojoules per mole to score your final mark. Again, the answer is negative, so the reaction is exothermic. To summarise, energy is taken in to break bonds between atoms in the reactant, so bond breaking is an endothermic reaction. When bonds are formed, energy is released, so bond making is an exothermic reaction. An exothermic reaction will occur if more energy is released when new bonds are formed than what was needed to break them. An endothermic reaction will occur if the energy taken in to break the bonds exceeds that released when new bonds are formed. Bond energies can be used to calculate the enthalpy change of a reaction, which can identify whether that reaction is exothermic or endothermic. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.